Hey everybody, what's going on? Thanks for checking out my YouTube channel. We have something kind of cool today. While I'm hanging out here with Vader, what you're actually looking at is the beginnings of setting up my movie room. I have my television here sitting on a cube system, and inside each cube is going some of my Star Wars themed props, many of which you've seen right here on this channel. My Sith Wayfinder, for example, sits in my little Sith nook, which also sits with, like, my Sith Holocron, for example. Some things you have seen on my Instagram channel, like my my bounty tracker from The Mandalorian. Luke Skywalker's most recent lightsaber, which also sits with my Sacred Jedi text, which you saw in my first episode of Chronicle that I did, Chronicles of the Wills. And so, all different little nooks have different things. Vader is my only one-to-one life-size statue that I have out in the living room. You guys have seen that video. At least 10,000 of you have seen it. Thank you for making that a very popular video. But it's a repainted Ruby's Supreme. A lot going on. And, yeah, I'm not wearing it so much, so I figured I might as well just display it when I'm not wearing it. But I thought to myself, it needs something else. There needs to be something more going on than just a life-size Vader. One thing that I thought about doing was displaying my Jakku-specific remade BB-8. And it wasn't a terrible idea. I liked it a lot. And he still functions. So, here's a lot going on with little BB-8 here. He still has his little, whatchamacallit, this thing. Little, thumbs-up gimmick. So, it wasn't quite doing it for me. So, what you saw here behind me is what I need to really be working on. And that is the one-to-one Yoda. So, I'm not going to say who I got this from, because it turns out who I got it from is a recaster, and I'm not going to give them the time of day. That's kind of bullshit. But it is a recast of somebody else's sculpt. I saw there were multiple lines, multiple seams, which states that it was a mold of a mold, and the second mold didn't have the same seam lines as the original mold, which kind of sucks. But you can see the original coloring of the resin cast here, and this is a hand. It's a solid piece. And so I immediately went in with a lot of different fillers, sanding, a lot of different methods to kind of hide the casting seams, which are still a little prevalent. It's very hard with a recast. The more it's recasted, the worse the seams tend to get. Tried to cover up as many air bubbles as possible with filler and different things. And we've gone and we started just darkening them up, and then lightening them again, and just a lot of layers of acrylic paints with different wash levels. And so the hands are all set, the feet, and again, I did not make them 100% symmetrical. I tried to vary them up a little bit, so we can go ahead and see how the feet look. This one's darker than this one, for example. And on the bottom of the feet, I already started gunking this one up. I'm going to put some brown on the bottom just to make them gunky, even though I'm probably going to drill these into place. We're not going to see these too much, but what everybody really wants to see is the head. The head was a difficult paint, but I'm really happy with the paint so far. I had to try a lot of different stuff because in Empire, which is the definitive look of Yoda, the seams of the latex, where all the crevices were, that's normally where the washes would sit, and they would be darkest, which is fairly normal when you do a wash. Something like, if you look at the lines in the hand here, you can see how the darker stuff sits in those crevices. You're listening to my dog eat a bone upstairs right now. Sorry about that. Sounds like the house is coming down. But you can't really do that with Yoda because the mask didn't do that. The lightest was the inner seams. So I couldn't do a wash over this. I had to paint mostly dry brushing. I did do a little bit of liquid in and around the eyes, which you can see. You know, we had to kind of get in there and do a little bit around the eyes and stuff to get some crevices I did want darker than others, but
for the most part, I wanted that lightness. You can really see it in the folds in the neck. I wanted the seam and the crease to be lighter, sort of like when you're heavy set and your neck rolls up on itself and you get a tan, you get those really awful white lines here because you're doing this all the time, looking at your phone. So I kind of wanted Yoda to have that because really when they stressed and moved the latex, the paint didn't hold. And so what you saw was that raw latex coming through a little bit more. So in the head, in the creases, it's lighter than it is everywhere else, so that at a distance, when it catches, you know, the lighting and things like that, it bleaches out the darkness that's on, like, the ridges and things like that. So in reality, if I turn this light off, you can see that Yoda's a little, you can see it a lot more that way, but Yoda comes out pretty dark. And if I back up, you can really see the lightness in the grid on his head. And so, you know, when you turn him and you get the profile, you know, I'm sorry, I'm a Frank Oz fan, so. But, you know, it's very dark in person. The reason I did that is because as you add more and more light to the subject, it bleaches him, and then you get that very bleached look in Empire, because in Empire, there was really an overhead spotlight on him, like, 90% of the time. And so that bleached look, if I'll just turn this for a minute, as you really get on top of a lighting system, it does bleach out and give that look. So the trick was actually not painting it light. The trick was painting it dark and then experimenting with lighting until it lit several ways the way that I liked. So again, as we get down into the base of the neck and the body, you can see there's really a lot less done there. Really just some general dry brushing. But again, he's going to have a half collar that comes up and covers a good chunk of this. He's going to be tipped forward ever so slightly. This little up ridge here is going to help with the hump on his back. He's probably just going to be holding both hands over his walking stick. And so the eyes, they're just literally dead center, straightforward. They are glass eyes, so acrylic eyes. So I did grind out the eye holes and attach those eyes inside, went up inside and attached the eyes that way. Getting them to line up and point the same direction was a bit of a pain in the ass, but it worked. And the color I went with, I know that Yoda's eyes were somewhat green in the prequels. They were green with a bit of brown, and ironically, they haven't used the same eyes over and over again. So what I decided to do was I found an eye I really liked, which had a dark green rim, very light green to yellow blend, and then a brown around the pupil. That, to me, was good enough. So I decided that's got a little bit of everything that covers all the bases, and it sits really well with him, and it looks really good. So from every angle, the paint holds, and it looks good. Now it's just a matter of fabric. I have a linen that I really want to use. You can see it doesn't have a ton of weathering built into it. I will add it. But if we were to just simply, and I got about 2 yards of this stuff, but if we were to just kind of wrap it for what he's already dealing with here, you know, you can see that that is going to be that lighter fabric. Again, I'm going to start with a lighter fabric because I'm going to add some weathering to it. I'm going to airbrush. I'm going to do some faraway spritzing. I'm going to build this robe and add to it. And I want it to be darker in certain places, but I want it to have enough lightness. And if I went with a darker, more detailed fabric, it wouldn't hold. It just wouldn't look right. I really don't know how I'm going to do this. I do have a Jedi tunic pattern, and a robe pattern for kids, which I'm going to try to use to match this. I have no clue how I'm going to do the brown part yet. I'm going to wing that 100%. But for the most part, this is going to... I could just display this as a bust, and it would look fine. But I, you know, Sideshow Collectibles did that. I want the full body. I want him 2 feet, 4 inches, I believe is how tall he's supposed to be, in Empire. So just, you know, 2.25 feet tall-ish, 60 centimeters roughly, you know, just kind of like in that sort of zone for all my international people here. And again, he's just going to have that, you know, that look. God, I wish it was a puppet, man. I just would just play with this all day. Oh, wars not make one great. Like, it's so much fun, dude. Just like having a Yoda full size. It wasn't an expensive investment either, but again, it was a recast. So if you're going to invest in somebody's Yoda cast, parts, I would definitely make sure that they sculpted it, you know, and it's not somebody ripping somebody else off, which unfortunately I did. So that's a mistake I got to deal with. But as you can see, like with the feet, the seams are extremely heavy on those, like really, really shitty. Really have to do something with that. But this is going to be mostly covered. So really, you're just going to catch a bit of the toes. So the plan now is to drill into the middle of each of these, because these are solid resin. They're not hollowed out. They are rock solid. So I'm going to drill into there, have two bendy stems that come out up to the hip joints. Same thing with the arms. Two bendy stems that'll come out and shape the arm. I will wrap that with some type of foam, probably upholstery foam. Then I'll wrap that with Saran wrap. So that'll give me a basic form that I can bend the arms and do things with. So if I want to have them do like this, or if I just want to have them sit like this, I can do that. That is the current plan. And then the body is just going to be some solid form of foam or wood or something. And again, maybe I'll pad it and wrap it just so it holds some shape. And then I'll just add additional padding as needed for the hump on the back and the shoulders and things like that. I will just add as I need it. I will probably build the tunic that he wears with the neck piece and everything. The trick with that is going to be I am going to have to get that around his neck, so I can't just make it close. I'm going to have to do some kind of Velcro or clasp where they overlap here, because if it doesn't wrap around and connect here, if I make this all connected or try to connect it in the back, I'm worried that it's not going to look right and I'm not going to be able to get it on the thing. So I have to figure that out, but it's not going to be a full body tunic. It's going to be like a dickie and then some forearm to wrist sleeves, and then maybe a strip around the leg area to show that, you know, that the robe goes all the way down. But, you know, it's going to be very much just what you see like to here. So it's going to be like this, and then it's going to be like a bib that comes down, and it's not going to be much more than that. And I'll probably attach that bib right to the form. And then the robe is really going to be the big effort. The other thing I'm going to have to do is, because I have to tear the robe in a lot of places, I'm going to have to put some brown fabric under those spots so that it exposes that. But I'm not building a full set of robes for the body form. It's just, I'm not that skilled. And I'm mostly using fabric tape to do all this. I can't sew. So that's going to be another problem I have to deal with. But yeah, while we're standing here, I mean, you guys have seen him before. You've seen Vader. But from the ground up, it's mostly Ruby stuff, but some parts have been redone. One of the things that I redid was I took out these, let me grab them really quick. I took out these, which come in the Ruby's boxes. I didn't like them, and I put actual mesh in here. So it's not the garden hose like it should be. It's just mesh, because that's what I had. I had a colander, so I cut out some pieces of the colander, put some black fabric behind it, and stitched that in. These buttons, these actually all light up. I don't know where the on switch is anymore. I kind of forgot, but there's an on switch on here. Oh, wait, here it is. So as you can see, the boxes light up. So I got my red dot here, my two greens. So they light up, and they work. So I'm still working on that. This does not light up. The electronics are all in it, but it's fucked. The person I bought it from rewired it to do some different stuff. I may change this up to match A New Hope and paint this white. I have to see. But, you know, the chest box is there. This has all been completely redone. I did this, with graphite powder and some different things, and I've shown that several times. So you guys have seen that. I haven't replaced this with the proper garden hose yet. The helmet, I've done to death. You guys have seen the helmet. It came with the sort of the Don Post reverse paint job look. And so I did, like, this cheek is the silver one. There's silver here, the dark black strip is this side instead of that side. But some scenes in Empire, they flip the camera and it does look like that. So also in Return of the Jedi. So to be honest with you, it's not inaccurate because they flip the camera sometimes. So it can be accurate to one scene or two scenes with that flip look. But it just was too much pain in the ass to flip it When in reality, the only reason they painted it that way is so that it would come up on camera better. It's not supposed, it's supposed to be all black, but it doesn't film as well. So they did some of this weird cross-colored painting, which everybody's super into, especially if you're 501st, fuck me. But I decided, just for shits and giggles, since I have two helmets, I did one of them in that style. And the fact that it was flipped didn't bother me, because like I said, in a few scenes, it was flipped. The cheek was on the left side, and it was on the right side. So it goes back and forth, which one is the super grade one. It depends on how they shot the film and flipped the camera. But I do have the Black Series helmet as well, which is my favorite helmet, because it's so detailed, even though the sculpt is not accurate. I love that, especially with just the bottom half. And you've seen a video where I wore this costume with just that. And I will be working with CB Studios in Australia to get some Anakin scars and things like that. Benefit of being bald is I don't have to wear a bald cap. So I just have to add some scars and stuff. So it should be pretty cool. I will do a burnt up Vader at some point. It'll prevent me from suffocating under this helmet. And this suit is so warm. And it's very hard to move in. I didn't cut vent holes in the back or anything. So you're sort of just like, you know, like it pulls down my shoulders. It rides up my crotch. So you're kind of like this all the time. It's not a fun suit to wear. You know, half hour, hour. And then you just want to get the hell out of it. But having the helmet off breathes much better. It makes it much more wearable. But again, with the Yoda, I thought who better, to have out with Vader than the counterpart, which is, you know, in my opinion, I think in Empire, that's really your big dynamic. It's not Obi-Wan, it's Yoda. Yoda's the big good guy. He's the big Jedi Master. And Darth is really the big bad on the Sith side, because you never see Palpatine in the original trilogy. And don't get me wrong, I love me some Palpatine. I'm a Palpatine guy, I'm a huge fan of his dialogue, and I like the way he works the scenes, but you know nothing about him in the OT. Like, you didn't know his name, he was just known as the Emperor, you didn't even know he was a Sith, you didn't even know there was such a thing as Sith, because they never used the name, you did not know, that he was even capable of using the Force until the last bit of Return of the Jedi, when he actually used it on Luke. We didn't really know why he was robed and everything like that. It was like, was he a Jedi? Was he a turned Jedi? We knew nothing. So, a lot of my friends, I was talking to my friend the other night about, oh, they didn't tell us anything about Snoke. I'm like, well, what the fuck did they tell us about Palpatine in the OT? Nothing. We knew nothing. So when they call him Senator Palpatine, everybody's like, oh, well, they gave it away. I'm like, you didn't even know the Emperor's name was Palpatine if all you saw was the movies. You never knew that. They never tell you that once. So for me, I kind of always go to Vader as the definitive Force user of the OT, because you really don't see Palpatine use anything until end of the third movie, which is fine. And I actually really liked the character Palpatine. He was really the only reason I watched the prequels. I think he was my favorite part. But when I had the opportunity to get a Vader, I was like, yes, I definitely want one because I want to be Vader. But I also thought I could display Vader in my house, and my wife is actually going to let me, which is what's even cooler. She won't let me put him here next to the television because she says he stares at her, so we're going to put him over there somewhere. But I'll have Vader, I'll have Yoda, I'll have BB-8, which is kind of cool. I have, which is something I did want to show off, I picked up this 3PO wall hanger, which is really cool. I do very much enjoy this. I have not put batteries in it, or I didn't, I took them out, but these light up, and so it's something that's meant to just sort of hang on your wall, but it's such a cool thing, because it's a 1-to-1 3PO head, and these are really cheap if you find them online right now. I probably will repaint this, but it does have a nice shine to it, and so if you gunk it up a little bit, it kind of has a Tatooine look. But one thing that's pretty cool is, if you take the back off this and pull this faceplate off, you can wear this. You could wear this and be 3PO, which is pretty fucking cool. That's not something that I expected. It's a very, very good investment, I feel. And the other main reason I like it... Ooh, there's the casting seam. The other main reason I like it is because it can display in a cube with my Babu Frick. Because Babu... Babu can be working on 3PO, and it makes displaying this little toy a lot cooler. Or if you have a 3D printed Babu, or if you have one of those $200 silicone Babus that are going around, this, you can take the back of this off and add all the wires and stuff coming out and make a really cool display cube. So I technically have a 1-to-1 3PO head that I display in my cube. So I do have a couple 1-to-1s, which is kind of fun. But the big one that everybody keeps hitting me back and forth about was, of course, the Baby Yoda pram. My interpretation of it for the smaller scale Baby Yoda figure, you know, Grogu. Again, I really was just super thrilled with how this came out, and I originally was going to put him where Yoda's currently sitting, although at the moment he's sitting in a cube. As you can see, it's pretty big. I mean, I'm 6'2", and so I'm pretty wide. I'm a fairly tall person, and you can see this is a pretty sizable pram. I did not add the orange ovals in on this yet. I have a little bit more nooks and crannies that I still have to kind of do with this thing, but it's mostly done. Again, I'm very, very happy with it. I like how deep this particular Yoda sits in there. Looks very, very appropriate. So, the pram was definitely a big focus on how I wanted to display my Star Wars room, because while I'm watching Mando, I got my Yodas out. My baby Yodas are out. They're out when I'm watching Mando. On this, I just got this new TV specifically for this season because I wanted to see Ahsoka and potentially Cal Kestis in Super HD. Like I have not been disappointed at all. So now that I got my Vader, now that Yoda is in the process of being done, my Star Wars room is pretty cool. The next step will be to put up some posters and potentially put some lightsabers on the wall. And this room is going to be half Star Wars, half Harry Potter, because that's my wife and I's favorite thing to do when we go down to Disney World. We also always go to Universal Studios and go to Harry Potter. We're very big into the books, and we like the movies as well. So a lot of Harry Potter. I just got my Snape costume, which I haven't done a video on YouTube yet, but I will. I love Alan Rickman. So, of course, I have a Snape, and I've been meaning to do that for a very long time. But the costume that I got has some imperfection, and I want to work on it before I do a video. So eventually I'll get to that. But yeah, overall, very, very, a lot of progress with my Star Wars room. Really happy with my Yoda build so far, but now I'm onto the hardest part and the part that I'm most out of my depth for, which is the soft parts. Making soft parts from scratch is not my thing. but I am going to do my best. I'm making a lot of Evil Dead Necronomicons right now. I still have my last couple to wrap up for this year. And then I start on next year's orders. So we're going right into next year's orders. I do have a few orders for next year. I'm currently waiting on paper because COVID. I get some of the paper that I use from New Zealand. And unfortunately, it's taking for friggin' ever. So hopefully I'll get that. For those of you guys who have seen Brett's Groovy Chainsaws, you will notice that the video that precedes this one is me impersonating and seemingly insulting Brett from Brett's Groovy Chainsaws. Not at all. We were running a contest on the Knights of Cimmeria page where we decided to roast ourselves, for lack of a better terms. And so Brett was the first one to open that up and say, for a video contest, you have to impersonate me being Brett. So I wanted people to understand that they could do that and it was okay. So I made the first one and I really went for it. And if you follow Brett's Groovy Chainsaws and you see a lot of his videos, which you should, please feel free to check that video out. That was made with love. Brett saw that video. He approved that video before it went up. So there's no animosity or anything like that. He was involved in that process. He actually laughed really hard at it. A lot of the group did. So if you're in the Knights of Cimmeria page, you've seen that video. But if you haven't, you're wondering what the hell that is. If you don't understand why he's freaking out about the Tots book or the Baby Yoda that's in that clip, you should check out what's going on in the Knights of Cimmeria page. Finnegan, don't do that. So, yeah, a lot of love there. Check out his page for anything and all things Evil Dead related. Really, it's my favorite Evil Dead page. And, of course, if you're looking for Evil Dead props, you got to go to the KnightsOfCimmeria.com, or you have to join the Facebook group Knights of Cimmeria. I have really put a halt on theKnightsOfCimmeria.com. I have not had the time. So my plan is to try to relaunch it back in 2021 when I get some time. But right now, it's taking every waking moment I have to do some of what I'm doing here, my necros, and keep my business up and running for my owner, because it's just, there's a lot going on with COVID and regulations and stuff, and trying to stay open is a struggle. So I really don't have a lot of time. When I do, I'm just too damn tired to sit down at the computer and bust out a bunch of files and stuff. So Hopefully they'll get back to it. Hopefully I'll get back to some of the digital files that I have to do for other props that I'm working on. And hopefully you guys enjoyed this little look at Yoda. I'll do a longer one when I finish him. maybe I'll do one before or after I do the cane. I'll probably just do it when the body's done and forget the cane. And I'll get the cane done at some point. But I'll do another video when that's completely done and show you guys what that looks like. But for the most part, this is the work in progress. If you're curious, I mean, I use very basic paints. This particular one was the base coat that I used for him. This is called Deco Art Americana Decor Curb Appeal. And it's known as Cottage Moss. Is its front door and shutter paint. I believe it's a latex paint. And so this particular paint is what I use. It's actually a paint I use upstairs in my house. But that was the base coat that I started that with. And then I used more of like a castle grayskull. The greens that I used for that. A lot of grayskull paint has made its way onto Yoda. But I would mix that with black or brown to give it a different look. And then at the very end, I went over it with some green and white, very light highlight, but very desaturated. There's not a lot of saturation to the greens that I'm using. By building up the various desaturated greens to give the illusion of saturation, but you don't want Yoda to come off too green. So a lot of the paint that I'm using is a very desaturated, grayed out shades of green. I don't really have an intense green. And when I do have that, it's either washed out, mixed with brown, and done in very, very light coatings. Very, very light. So you don't want to make it too green. The next thing I got to do is I got to get a Santa beard for the curly bits and add some hair. You know, hair in the ears, on the sideburns, and around the back here. Kind of like my hair. And get that going. And that'll call that a day. And then some gloss paint over these nails so that they spark a little bit. And then go in with some browns and some blacks and put the dirt into the nails. And, you know, paint the wart on the chin and the eyebrow with that sort of really dark blackish green and get that going. So, yeah, there's some last steps to do, but it's going pretty good. I hope everybody enjoyed it, and hopefully I'll get this done before the new year. Probably not, but maybe I will. I'm taking some PTO, so maybe I'll have some time to do it. But the main thing I'm looking to do is clean out my movie room and finish that up and make it look nice. So hopefully that'll work out. I got to go glue some bindings. So I'm going to go do that. I got to paint some covers. Got to go do that. So hopefully that doesn't take up my whole day. I'm waiting for the Giants to start playing, actually, so I can go watch that game. But yeah, thanks everybody for checking it out. My videos always ramble for about a half hour. But thanks a lot. Hopefully my Star Wars room comes out as badass as I'm hoping it will be. But right now, pretty happy with it. So may the Force be with us. And fuck yes for the Mandalorian.